Good morning, 47. Your destination is the coastal town of Sapienza, also known as the Jewel of the Amalfi Coast. Your target is a former client of ours, Silvio Caruso, a brilliant but troubled bioengineer employed by the Ether Biotech Corporation. Renowned for his early stem cell research, Caruso is now reportedly working on a far more disturbing project, a DNA-specific virus able to infect anyone, anywhere in the world. Imagine a bullet, fired in any direction, passing through countless bodies without inflicting harm, invisible and undetectable until it strikes its target. A world of armchair assassins killing with impunity. This is what awaits us, unless Caruso is stopped. Our client, one of Ether's major private stockholders, wants the project cancelled on ethical grounds, but without destroying the company in the process. She has asked us to eliminate Silvio Caruso and destroy the yet unfinished virus prototype. You will also need to deal with Caruso's lab head, Francesca DeSantis, a high-level Ether employee and cutthroat corporate climber who holds intimate knowledge of Caruso's research and could potentially carry on in his place. This is no ordinary contract, 47. Caruso's virus is a serious threat to our craft and trade, not to mention our core ideals. So failure is not an option. I'll leave you to prepare. Welcome to Sapienza 47. Silvio Caruso's family home is right across the square. The bioengineer suffers from acute travel phobia, so the Ether Corporation has installed a state-of-the-art field laboratory somewhere below ground. Expect security levels to rise as you get closer to the virus. Good luck, 47.
Lovely day.
You didn't tell me your cousin was back in town.
Ah, do I detect a certain attraction to the dashing private detective from Milan?
Oh, what of it? He's cute.
Actually, well, I really shouldn't tell you this, but he's here about a case. The client is Francesca DeSantis. You know, the female doctor that's staying at Villa Caruso.
Really? Wonder what she wants with a snoop.
Well, you didn't hear it from me, okay? Where'd you see him, anyway?
Couple of streets over, sleeping on a bench.
Yeah. Well, that's Sal for you. Always was a nighthawk.
Thank you.
Not the subtle type, are we?
What?
Anyone there? God, this is pissing me off.
Mr. Santis, Sal Falcone. Sorry for the delay. I needed to tie up some few loose ends. Yeah, just got into town. Down at the pier?
Sure.
Straight away? All right, no time like the present. See you in a bit.
Huh. Sexy voice.
Are you kidding? Pick a page out of the history books. No, man, whatever they're doing over at Villa Felipa.
Yeah, it's Sal. Well, now what did I tell you, Curly? Once a cheat, always a cheat. Trust me, Curly, there's nothing I would like to do more than follow your wife around town. Again. But, you know, I'm on a case, down in Sapienza. Didn't Marlena in reception tell you? Ah, Christ, you know, what do I pay her for? Anyway, I got a split, Curly. I'm waiting for an address here. Look, I'll give you word when I get back, you know? We'll shoot some pool, get you back on your feet, all right?
Oh,
yes,
Curly.
Hello. I'd like to be table
you
for two.
You human punching bag.
Thank you.
they say, you can take the boy out of the city, but you can't take the city out of the boy. So, what's this about, Miss DeSantis? Running errands for Caruso now? Now, you seem somewhat, overqualified.
Not exactly. Walk with me, Mr. Falco.
Candles.
Right. Mr. Falcone, what I am about to ask you might be considered unethical.
Please, you know how I spend most of my nights? On top of a garbage can, shooting pictures through the window of a strip club. I mean, I'm one step above an ambulance chaser, so just, you know, shoot.
Very well. About a month ago, Silvio Caruso hired you for an acquisition job. I need to know what exactly it was you acquired, and I'm willing to pay you handsomely.
All right, I'll tell you. And it's not just for the money. It was a strange request. Never sat right with me. Felt wrong.
Tell me what happened.
Well, it's late at night. Caruso, he hands me a list. You know, like a list of names. Wants me to get DNA samples. You know, blood, hair, saliva, skin samples. And naturally, I ask what it's for, and he goes vague. Calls it a research study. Yeah, I know he's at least half lying, but I'm strapped for cash, so I take the job.
So, these names, who are they?
That's the strange bit. A school teacher, an environmental lawyer, a graphics designer. There's one guy, he rescues sea turtles. You know, I ask him what gives, and I'll never forget his answer. He says, all bullies grow up, Mr. Falcone, and their crimes are forgotten. But sometimes the weak turn strong, and the tables are turned.
I was right. All those kids who did him wrong, he's getting back at all of them. Thank you, Mr. Falcone. You have done well. I must go now.
How you doing?
Okay, are you ready? I need a silence, please. Let's.
Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Jeez.
Hello?
Everything quiet on your front?
DeSantis.
Entering the Aether Lab requires a key card and a uniform. Luckily, it seems both are within reach.
His behavior is getting more and more erratic. In many ways, Caruso is still a child. A scared, angry little boy with the power of God at his fingertips. I am almost certain now that he killed his mother. Strangled her in a fit of rage. How long before he turns that rage towards us. If Dr. Lafayette pulls off a miracle, fine. Otherwise, I see little choice but to go the other way. Well, you wanted my recommendation. Excuse me, that is none of your concern. Roberto is a distraction, nothing more. I am well aware. It's quite to be expected. Caruso is not exactly used to female company, is he? Believe me, everything is under control. Now, if you'll pardon me, there's something I need to investigate.
Just look for a combination code like this. Not that.
Caruso's got the mic.
Okay, let's see what you're up to, Silvio. What's this? DNA samples. Oh, Silvio. Oh, you've really gone off the deep end, haven't you? What's this? Medical prescription. Anti-anxiety. Strong stuff.
memoirs. To be published posthumously. Draft one. Notes on the Samael project. Ongoing. I can no longer claim objective detachment. I am deeply, profoundly immersed in the project. Sometimes when I look at my creation through the microscope, I feel like I'm gazing into the proverbial abyss, and the abyss gazes back. Yet, my monster is nothing like Oppenheimer's. The atomic bomb was brutish and tyrannical. Mine is democratic. It will turn everything around. Ether thinks they can control it, but they can't. I won't let them. This is a weapon for the powerless. In this time, the bullies, with all their money and all their strength, will not be the ones to define the future. Yes, I like the sound of that.
Careful out there.
There.
Sir, if you'd only tell me, what...
Didn't you hear? That was her sick bell, just like last time. First, the record, then the stair lift, and now, the sick bell. Like a trail of breadcrumbs, like she is calling me to enter. Don't you understand?
I...
I'm going inside.
Like the gear.
If you want to pass, you need to comply to a frisk, sir.
Nothing to worry about. It's simple protocol. Thank you. You can pass.
Prototype will be close by. Look for some type of quarantine unit.
What's up, Doc?
Okay, so walk me through this.
Right. Well, this is the control panel for the air purification system. We're at a critical stage of development. We keep the central hub perpetually doused in chemicals.
In case of an outbreak?
Yes. We use a unique compound that breaks down the protein coating, which protects the virus, effectively killing it by damaging its DNA and RNA, so it neither infects cells nor replicates within the cells.
Belts and suspenders, huh?
You better believe it. In its natural state, the prototype could infect and kill everyone inside this lab in a matter of minutes. The most ferocious organism you've ever seen.
Thank you. Duly noted.
So this is where Ms. DeSantis keeps all the research data. Keeps this stuff pretty close to her chest.
Why? We all signed an NDA the size of a phone book.
Yeah, well, there was this incident a while ago. A researcher made a copy of the hard drive and tried selling it to one of Ether's competitors. Got himself killed, luckily, or we'd all be out of a job. Just seriously, don't touch anything. They're in the middle of a test, and you don't want to corrupt that data, believe me.
Right, and, yeah, thanks.
Huh, that's odd. Decay levels ought to be stabilizing.
Readings are good.
Warning, danger, compound. Warning, danger, compound. Processing.
Damn it! Hey, who just left this here like this? Seriously.
Thank you.
Objectives complete. Now head towards an exit.
Team meeting at 5. Be there.
Mental note. Ask Guillermo to run a controlled experiment.
Thank you.
Ether Security's in the dark about the incident. A few of the company knew about the virus, not even the board. Must have been someone at the lab. I understand. I'll get to the bottom of this.
Boss is unhappy. I followed you from Italy. I guess when you're invisible, you stop looking over your shoulder.
You did this.
Iago exposed you. ICA did the heavy lifting. I just pulled some strings.
Yeah, you mind? How do you expect...
I play dirty. That's how you defeat a stronger opponent. You strike from behind. Now give me the key.
You have a family? Trust me, if there's a weakness, Providence will find it.
I'll take my chances. The key.
Fine. Won't do you much good.
It's funny. Cobb said the same thing. Thank you, messenger.
Don't. I just killed you.
Then we're even.